Wow.
How you feel?
I feel vulnerable, exposed, and also like proud.
I think I found a way to keep myself whole. I write my fears on green notes.
Have you ever taken the time to lean into and understand your past, your childhood, and your subconscious motivations? Have you ever taken the time to understand how your past affects your daily actions? For the last 70 days, I've faced myself in a manner unlike ever before, peeling back every possible layer to my core.
What are we doing today?
We're skydiving.
All right, first time?
First time.
You excited?
Yeah.
Some of the realizations have been massive and difficult to digest.
The thing that kept coming to me was push past the pain, and I just kind of get it out of my head.
I learned I'd been steering my life based on directions from a faulty GPS. It didn't matter how hard I tried to make changes because the core operating system was hardwired incorrectly.
You know, I've just been thinking about like how I always see the good in every situation or the positive. And on one end, well, it's good to see potential in people, right? When you just see the potential, you never de-risk the situation.
My GPS was programmed incorrectly because of how I grew up. After being scarred from a parent's divorce and the events thereafter, I did everything I could in my power to not repeat the cycle of the events growing up. I promised myself to stay in excellent physical shape so I could support my dreams on my own. I prioritized work above all else.
And I told myself that once I found professional success, I would build a family and protect them from a similar outcome.
I never made a choice that didn't align with my principles.
They became my hard wiring, and that wiring formed the parameters of my comfort zone.
Of course, like any operating system, there are upsides and downsides. On one hand, my regimented approach taught me how to plan my actions, be consistent, and track my goals. On the other hand, it caused me to bulldoze my way through life. Oftentimes, I was so unable to enjoy the moment because I was so focused on staying the course. Under the direction of that GPS, I saw working as the ultimate priority. I stuck to a prescribed strategy rather than letting go in the name of serendipity. I preferred to be in control of my path at all times, even if that meant letting go and following an intuition that I should be somewhere else. Because of that tight grip on life, it became very hard to stay present and show up emotionally and allow myself to take a detour, even when it felt right. My fear of loss forced me to stay on my predetermined path. If something took me off the path, I feared I would lose sight of my destination permanently. That sometimes prevented me from showing up for others when they needed me the most, such as in my most important relationships. Additionally, that fear of loss stripped me from being able to see my own value.
Because I was so scared of losing what was right in front of me, I couldn't understand what had attracted those opportunities to me in the first place, and that was myself.
Realizing I didn't value and love myself made me face a hard truth. I never felt whole on my own. I searched for completeness in external sources such as work and relationships. And when those external forces shifted, my self-worth shifted along with it too.
As I reflect on where I am on this journey, I can see how far I've come, even in a very short amount of time.
I have become a new person living with a new operating system. That system has led me into an uncomfortable abyss. It has taken me on many detours with less predetermined outcomes. But when I veer off that path, I don't fear losing control.
And that feels pretty powerful.
Just did a 52 degree cold plunge.
You can do it. I feel like you can do it. You're owning this one.
Tracking how my pain has informed my past choices has been the most profound experience of my life. It has given me the opportunity to ask the question, what does a complete Brian look like?
Now I finally have the chance to lean in and figure that out. While I have an idea of who I want to become and how I want to show up in the world, this is the first time I'm not searching for a playbook of how to get there.
I am leaning into my feelings and awareness. of what makes me come alive on my own. Now I'm your passenger. The old-